Here in a shady corner of a great thriving metropolis stands that fortress of education and thought, Washburn High School. In an atmosphere of serenity and propriety, young Americans prepare to be responsible, leading citizens in our great democratic society. But all is not proper. All is not serene. For in another part of town, brilliant and yet tragically misguided intellects are engaged even now in a diabolical scheme to pervert these purposes and demolish these dreams. The troublesome twosome, the sorcerer and Professor Sin, search for the secret formula that will transform good into evil and evil into worse. Serendipity is this? In violence and chaos it is born. The promise of impending pestilence. The tyrannical tool of the troublesome twosome. The devastating dirty pill. But now, to use this cruel concoction. To the school. To the foundation of democracy. It is a typical day at Washburn High School. Unsuspecting scholars go about their usual duties, their minds filled with profound and yet wholesome thoughts. Thoughts of science, mathematics, history, clean literature. Thoughts soon to be replaced by evil ones if the sordid scheme succeeds. Is this really typical? Silently they arrive, the harbingers of havoc. Uncertain, suspicious, stealthy, as evil ones always are. Never able to walk proudly in a public place, for the troubled conscience is always fearful. The troublesome twosome, and their depraved entourage, ready even now to spread their poison through the hallowed halls of ivy. At this moment, in a typical Washburn classroom, typical Washburn students bend their agile minds in the pursuit of knowledge. Did we say typical? Two of these fine young people are not typical. Can you pick them out? Only their typical Washburn teacher knows for sure, and their secret is safe with him. Have the evil geniuses blundered? Do they know of the presence of the dynamic duo? Or do they know all too well? Will they be more than a match for Batman and Boy Wonder? What is this? Now we see it clearly. Smut has already partially infiltrated the school. This has clearly been an inside job. Thank you. is there no stopping this sophomoric saturnalia? Hurry, dynamic duo, hurry! Even now, Washburn students are being cleverly drawn into the criminal band by these masters of deception. At last, now justice will be served. The plot will be foiled. Look out, Batman. Look out! A poisoned handkerchief! Poor misguided girl. Poor dynamic duo. Betrayed by their own chivalrous instincts. Oh no, what will they do with Boy Wonder? Is this the end for Robin? Have we seen the demise of the dynamic duo? Sports at Washburn are played with energy and enthusiasm. This fine bit of action was expertly photographed by one of our promising amateur photographers. If he makes this jump, he can move the bar up to 4 feet. While Washburnites play, workmen are rushing to finish the proposed addition. Watch this beautiful throw. Wind down. Whirl. Release. And follow through. Faculty members learn to enjoy life at their favorite hangouts. Washburn High School is always full of interesting personalities. Other sports enjoy great popularity at Washburn as well. Congratulations, Dave. Guess what you just won? Back to our story. But wait, all is not lost. Breath still stirs in Batman's bronchi. That noble heart still beats. Whoops! Now, will he find them? Where have they hidden? Where is filth most likely to be found? Will the keen intellect of this great crime fighter pick up their trail? Will the skill and excellence of Batman foil their scream? Is there any doubt? Concealed hideout, the evil ones return to torture their prisoner and perfect their decadent discovery.
Thank you.
The basic formula of the dirty pill is a cunningly conceived good and evil exchange resin, which when charged with evil is capable of ionically binding virtue and releasing in its place vice. They are now adding to this evil pill a concentrate of the worst evils known to mankind. Greasy kid stuff. Concentrated stomach acid. Post-nasal drip. But what are they doing now? Don't take it, boy wonder, don't take it. Surely if the powerful virtue of this stout lad does not make him immune, no one is safe. And now they torture him, heartlessly, callously, senselessly, ridiculously. Courageous crime fighter searches. The clever corruptors left no clues, so Batman must systematically search all known strongholds of evil. Recesses of these devious minds. Detestable, abominable, not nice, and yet pitiful, produced by an unhappy childhood with no bright toys to pass the dreary hours, no green parks in which to laugh and play, nothing but frustration and emotional deprivation. If only someone had cared then, what misery could have been spared us now? Now, after giving Boy Wonder one last parting shot, the evil ones take their leave. What? In their hateful haste, they have made a crucial error. They forgot the dirty pill. And here comes the Cape Crusader. Quickly he evaluates the nearly impregnable fortress and finds the flaw that allows him to make his startling entrance. Cleverly disguised, Batman is always suspicious of a trap, but his hawk-like eyes see no danger, and so he relaxes ever so slightly. Your old friend is here, Boy Wonder. Wake up! ¶¶ But wait, Boy Wonder is still under the power of the evil potion. Cool and analytical in the face of overwhelming complexity, Batman strives to save his stricken sidekick. Perhaps this will work. Better try again, courageous crime fighter. Again intact. But now, to reverse the effect of the evil potion, instant comprehension and intense concentration will be needed to save the day and foil the wicked plan. Might as well take a few samples for the Bat computer. Molecular configuration has been reversed. The dirty pill has now become the clean pill, thanks to the excellence of this great team. The great Batman explains to his youthful understudy the clues he used to find this carefully concealed criminal hideaway. Well acquainted with the nature of evil, Batman knew that they would be likely to choose a location rich in smut. But he also knew that they would know that he knew that they would do so. Furthermore, he was certain that they would suspect, that he would guess, that they might know, that he knew about the way that they would try to make him think, that they would know, that he might suspect, that they would be sure to be here. And they were. Fine deduction, Batman. What a mind! How can any criminal hope to outwit this superlative intellect? Truly, this is one of the most significant reasons that crime does not pay. The unsuspecting Wicked One returns to retrieve his forgotten dirty pill. He is unaware that his doom has been already sealed. He doesn't even notice that Robin is gone. What can you expect from a high school dropout? The evil ones have again entered Washburn High School and have already begun to carry out their evil plot. Oh, what devious minds are these? What can be more devastatingly deceptive than to mix the dirty pill with nature's most nearly perfect food? It is a typical day at the Washburn lunchroom. Happens. troublesome twosome realize that their arch enemies have won the day. Away they run, but will away they run, but will they escape? The dynamic duo remain one step ahead of the evil ones. Even now they are waiting and ready for action. Punishment in proportion to their great crime. To their typical Washburn classroom. To them, it is all in the day's work, for these two daring dynamos are ready at any time of the day or night to answer the call of a citizen in distress. What is this? The bat phone again? But that is another story.